was forbidden in those days. My father opposed my aspiration of acquiring education. Furthermore, I was married at a very young age of 11 to Justice Ramabai Ranade, who was a social activist. Though I was an illiterate, but my husband was a graduate of Bombay University. In that time, when reading or writing was considered as a taboo for a girl, my husband supported me and educated me in spite of severe conflict at home. Besides giving me regular lessons in reading and writing in various subjects, he used to discuss current affairs with me to help me develop strong intellect. Justice Ranade relentlessly worked against untouchability, child marriage and sati pratha. I wanted to follow my husband's footsteps in working towards strong social reforms. I began working for the Pratna Samaj in Bombay and established a branch of Aramela Samaj in the city. Another social establishment, the Hindu Ladies Social and Literary Club in Bombay, was a platform to train women in languages, general knowledge and skill-based work like tailoring and handwork. But my guiding light, my husband, Justice Ranade, died in 1901. His reform activities of social awakening became my life's aim. To make women self-reliant and literate, Seva Sadan was initiated. I strongly believe that education can improve the social status of women. Women deserve equal status in society and right to education. I encourage women to take nursing as vocation. It was very difficult to convince young girls and widows to join the nursing course as the orthodox thinking of the people created barrier in opting this stream as profession. Because of persistent effort, Seva Sadan expanded and branched into many social and educational organizations. I visited the central prison, especially the women's wing, and visit to the boys in the reformatory school, I hope kindle self-esteem in them. Visits to patients in local hospitals, organizing relief for famine-stricken people and volunteering to rent a hand to women pilgrims visiting the shrines, augmented my urge to extend whatever little I could do for the needy. Who better than me will understand the importance of education, extending compulsory and pre-primary education to girls and organizing women's suffrage movement in Bombay Presidency in 1921-22 was steps towards strengthening the position of women in society so that they can exist as confident citizens of the society. I received the love, affection and support of the people, but I will always remain a shadow of my husband who illuminated my path with his support.